वेलकम क्लास, वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन सेकेंड बुक स्नैपशॉट ऑफ क्लास 11 कोर्स एंड हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 1 द समर ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल व्हाइट हॉर्स. द राइटर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज विलियम सारायन, हु इज एन आर्मेनियन अमेरिकन नॉवलिस्ट, प्ले राइट एंड शॉर्ट स्टोरी राइटर. ही वॉज कन्फर्ड विद द पुलित्ज़र प्राइज फॉर ड्रामा इन द ईयर 1940 एंड ही ऑल्सो वॉन द अकेडमी अवार्ड फॉर बेस्ट स्टोरी राइटिंग and the film adaptation of his famous novel The Human Comedy. It also got much appreciation by the public. The story revolves around two poor Armenian boys who are fond of riding horses. Aram, that is 9-year-old boy, and Murad, 13-year-old boy, both belong to the Gargolin tribe whose people are well known for their honesty and trust. Murad in the story is able to steal a horse, and after enjoying riding for a month, he invites his cousin to join him in the horse riding. But ultimately, they decided to return the horse to its owner, as they didn't want to bring any shame for their family. Let's find out the reason of returning their fonded horse back to its owner. One day back there in the good old days when I was 9 and the world was full of every imaginable kind of magnificence and life was still a delightful and mysterious dream, my cousin Murad, who was considered crazy by everybody who knew him except me, came to my house at 4 in the morning and woke me up, tapping on the window of my room. The boy remembers here how in his childhood he was just 9 years old and his world just like the fantasy, full of extremely beautiful experience, and his life, it was also full of delightful, pleasant and like the suspense world. My cousin Murad, who was considered crazy by everybody who knew him except me, came to my house. He said it was the time when his cousin Murad, who was considered to be the craziest person in our tribe, came to my house at 4 o'clock. His cousin Murad, who was considered to be the craziest boy in the tribe, he came at 4 o'clock in the morning and tapped his window and woke him up. Aram, he said, I jumped out of bed and looked out of the window. I couldn't believe what I saw. He said that when I looked outside, I found my cousin Murad. He was standing there. It was not morning yet, but it was summer, and with daybreak not many minutes around the corner of the world, it was light enough for me to know I was not dreaming. My cousin Murad was sitting on a beautiful white horse. I stuck my head out of the window and rubbed my eyes. Yes, he said in Armenian, it is a horse. You are not dreaming. Make it quick if you want to ride. Describe, though it was an early morning summer day, but there was enough light to see outside, which made him believe that he was not dreaming. He found his cousin Murad. He was sitting on a beautiful white horse, and even he was giving him offer to be quick and join with him for the ride. I knew my cousin Murad enjoyed being alive more than anybody else who had ever fallen into the world by mistake. Though Aram says he clearly knows the nature of his cousin, who only want to make the enjoyment in the life than anybody else in the world. But the thing which he is now finding before his eyes, really he couldn't believe. In the first place, my earliest memories had been memories of horses, and my first longing had been longing to ride. Longing stands for desire. It was his longest desire to have the horse, and he used to dream always to ride the horse. Really, it was a wonderful sight to see now the beautiful white horse with his cousin Murad. In the second place, we were poor. This was the part that wouldn't permit me to believe what I saw. So that's why it was really unbearable for Aram to believe how the boy of the tribe could afford to buy a horse. We were poor. We had no money. Our whole tribe was poverty-stricken. Every branch of the Gargolian family was living in the most amazing and comical poverty in the world. Gargolian family, this is actually the Armenian tribe. Here the boy remarks that how the people and their tribe who had been so poor and had no money, how they are getting the food to fill their stomach. Even the oldest one of their tribe, they could also survive. Most important of all, though we were famous for our honesty, we had been famous for our honesty for something like 11 centuries, even when we had been the wealthiest family in what we like to think was the world. Now the boy started appreciating his tribe. He says they were known for their honesty and integrity since 11th century. Then their tribe was known to be the wealthiest one in the world. We were proud first, honest next, and after that we believe in right and wrong. So here the boy exaggerated the qualities of his tribe. He says that they are tribal people, so they are so proud of their tribe and its honesty. Whatever may be the circumstance, they keep always honesty and sincerity at first hand. So that's why they knew to make the difference between right and wrong. None of us would take advantage of anybody in the world. He says that's why the tribe and the people of it, they never cheat anyone and let alone steal. He said we never make advantage of anybody. So that's why we can never think that anyone can do the stealing. Now from this expression of the boy, we can understand the liking and fondness of these boys for the horse. So he says even he was looking the horse now standing before him, which was looking so magnificent. Magnificent, that means extremely beautiful. Even though I could smell it, so lovely. So he's finding even the smell of the horse to be very lovely. Even though I could hear it breathing, so exciting. So he even praised the breathing sensation of the horse too. He said he found everything of the horse to be the beautiful and so lovely and so exciting. I could believe the horse had anything to do with my cousin Murad or with me or with any of the other members of the family. So that's why he could never believe that the horse could have with the any family members of their tribe, whether asleep or awake. So whether they are sleeping or awake, so in any condition, their tribal people can never afford the horse. Because I knew my cousin Murad could not have bought the horse, and if he could not have bought it, he must have stolen it. So he started believing that certainly if this boy could never purchase the horse, so definitely he had stolen it. And I refuse to believe here. No member of the Gargolian family could be a thief. Still, he didn't want to believe that anyone of their tribe could be a thief. I stared first at my cousin. He first gazed at his cousin and then at the horse. There was a pious stillness. Pious is a very sacred or the innocent feeling and humor in each of them. So Aram observed the feeling of innocency and enjoyment in both, which on the one hand delighted me and on the other hand frightened me. So this now created the feeling of this on the first hand amused him and then it frightened the boy. Murad, I said, where did you steal this horse? Leap out of the window, he said, if you want to ride. When the boy tried to inquire from Murad about the stealing, instead of replying, he called him out for the ride. It was true then, he had stolen the horse. Thus, Aram understood that this was a stolen horse. There was no question about it. He had come to invite me to ride or not, as I choose. So he was giving him offer whether he want to join or not. Well, it seemed to me stealing a horse for a ride was not the same thing as stealing something else, such as money. Now, after getting the temptation of the horse right now, this boy, Aram, he was also melted in emotion. He started consoling himself by thinking that stealing the horse is not like the stealing of the money. For all I knew, maybe it was not stealing at all. He said, it is not at all the stealing like the money. If you were crazy about horses the way my cousin Murad and I were, it was not stealing. He said, if you have liking and fondness like us for the horses, you would also take for granted the stealing. It would not become stealing until we offer to sell the horse. He said, till the time we will keep it only for the ride, it is not stealing. And they knew it. They are never going to sell the horse, which of course I knew we would never do. Let me put on some clothes, I said. All right, he said. But hurry, I leaped into my clothes. Leap means jump. I jumped down to the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind my cousin Murad. Aram was overexcited to get this offer. So he asked few minutes and then directly he jumped from the window to the yard and sat behind Murad. That year we lived at the edge of the town on Walnut Avenue. Behind our house was a country, vineyards, orchards, irrigation ditches and country roads. In less than 3 minutes, we were on the Olive Avenue and then the horse began to trot. Here, the boy informs that they were living at the boundary of the Walnut Avenue that year, and behind their house was a countryside. Countryside means the village side that was full of vineyards. Vineyards are the grape gardens. Orchards, that means the fruit gardens. Irrigation ditches. Irrigation ditches are the watering lands. And the country roads and the village roads. Says that there was a vast countryside full of orchards, vineyards and irrigation ditches nearby. In a few moments, both Aram and Murad were having a wonderful time riding the horse and they reached in the Olive Avenue. And then the horse began to trot. On reaching there, the horse started jumping now. The air was new and lovely to breathe. The feel of the horse running was wonderful. Now while sitting on the horse, both the boys enjoyed and amused as the air was also blowing very fresh and lovely in the morning time. My cousin Murad, who was considered one of the craziest members of a family, began to sing. With the fact Murad, as he was considered to be the craziest one in the tribe, he started singing with the fresh feel of this fresh air. And then the horse began to trot. On reaching there, the horse started jumping now. The air was new and lovely to breathe. The feel of the horse running was wonderful. Now while sitting on the horse, both the boys enjoyed and amused as the air was also blowing very fresh and lovely in the morning time. My cousin Murad, who was considered one of the craziest members of a family, began to sing. With the fact Murad, as he was considered to be the craziest one in the tribe, he started singing with the fresh feel of this fresh air. Just out of excitement and enjoyment, he started roaring over there. Every family has a crazy streak in it somewhere, and my cousin Murad was considered the natural descendant of the crazy streak in our tribe. Before him was our uncle Khusrov, an enormous man with a powerful head of black hair and the largest mustache in the Sain Aquin Valley. A man so furious in temper, so irritable, so impatient that he stopped anyone from talking by roaring. It is no harm. Pay no attention to it. Thus, Uncle Khusrov, he was before Murad considered to be the craziest one in their tribe. He had a powerful head of black hair and the largest mustache in the Sain Aquin Valley. So this valley, it is in the large interior valley in. That was all, no matter what anybody happened to be talking about. So this way he reacted. So whatever the others are talking about. Once it was his own son Eric running 8 blocks to the barber shop where his father was having his mustard trimmed to tell him the house was on fire. This man, Khusrau, sat up in the chair and roared, "It is no harm. Pay no attention to it." The barber said, "But the sun says your house is on fire." But Khusrau roared, "Enough. It is no harm, I say." So here, this funny now example of this man is given that how once a tragedy happened to his house and his son came running to inform him that their house was on fire. But he ignored again this tragedy with the words, "It is no harm, pay no attention." That moment, barber had to remind him that your house is on fire. But still, he say by emphasizing, "I said enough na, it is no harm." Barber was amused and tried to inform him that the boy has brought the information that your house is on fire. Khusrau again roared and did not pay attention to him, and he said, "Enough, I have told, it is no harm, I say." My cousin Murad was considered the natural descendant of this man, although Murad's father was Zurab, who was practical and nothing else. That is how it was in our tribe. A man could be the father of his son's flesh, but that didn't mean that he was also the father of his spirit. Vagrant means wander. So this means there are different kinds of people in the tribe who are unpredictable. That means moody and never settled anywhere. My cousin Murad was considered the natural descendant of this man, although Murad's father was Zurab, who was practical and nothing else. Here again, Arab mentions that Murad's father was Zurab, but he was considered to be the natural descendant of this uncle. That is how it was in our tribe. He said this was very common in their tribe. A man could be the father of his son's flesh, but that didn't mean that he was also the father of his spirit. This means a child could look like his father, but it is not compulsory that he could inherit his qualities and instinct. The distribution of various kinds of spirit of our tribe had been from the beginning capricious and vagrant. Capricious, that means unpredictable, and vagrant means wander. So this means there are different kinds of people in the tribe who are unpredictable, that means moody and never settled anywhere. We rode and my cousin Murad sang. Still the boys were riding, and Murad, he was singing loudly. For all anybody knew, we were still in the old country, where at least according to some of our neighbors, we belong. Now they reached in the countryside, where according to their neighbors, they actually belonged. We let the horse run as long as it felt like running. Next, the boys let the horse run as fast as could, because now they were in the open country land. At last, my cousin Murad said, "Get down, I want to ride alone." All of a sudden, Murad asked Aram to get down. He wanted to do ride alone. "Will you let me ride alone?" I asked. "This is up to horse," my cousin said, "get down." Now, he replied that it is up to horse whether he would let him ride or not. "The horse will let me ride," I said. So he was surprised how the animal would give permission on riding it. "We shall see," he said. "Don't forget that I have a way with a horse." "Well," I said, "anyway, you have with a horse, I have also. For the sake of your safety," he said, "let us hope so." "Get down," Murad explained him that he was thinking it was not safe for the young boy like Aram to ride alone. "All right," I said, "but remember, you have got to let me try to ride alone." But he again insisted that he must give him the chance to ride alone. I got down and my cousin Murad kicked his heels into the horse and shouted, "Wazir, run." When the narrator got down, Murad kicked his heels into the horse and gave the command. Wazir, run. The horse stood on its hind legs. Hind legs, these are the back legs. Snorted. Snorted, that means the loud sounds produced by the animals. And burst into a fury of speed. That was the loveliest thing I had ever seen. So thus, at his command, the horse stood on its hind legs first and then snorted and started now running very fast. So this was the wonderful and the loveliest sight ever viewed by the narrator.